It was July 8th, a vehicle traveling in northern Syria near Aleppo. There was a U.S. drone keeping an eye on it. They determined that al-Fadhli was in the vehicle and fired against him. Why did they want to get Muhsin al-Fadhli? Well, as the leader of the Khorasan group, that's an offshoot of al-Qaeda that has vowed to attack the United States, vowed to attack the West, and has the bomb-making capability by all accounts to do it. He was such a veteran operative. He's one of the few al-Qaeda members that it is said he was informed about the 9/11 attacks before they took place, and then in 2002 was involved in another series of terror attacks that involved U.S. Marines in Kuwait and a French cargo vessel. So all of this adding up to someone the U.S. wanted to take off the battlefield. Very interesting, though, he was in northern Syria. The U.S. may not have troops on the ground, but it has eyes and ears and the intelligence. When they found him, they took the shot.
This is a targeted drone strike taking place inside Syria. So how did the U.S. get the intel for this strike?
Well, the drones can fly overhead for a long period of time if they have an initial sense of where someone is, maybe from intelligence on the ground, maybe from intercepts of cell phone or media. They can send up a drone and track somebody. To be clear, we don't have the details about this, but it might be something that's very interesting to ISIS officials, say, to really understand that the U.S. can track them even when they don't have troops on the ground.